So here we have our double nukes. It's spring of the year. It's May 4th. We're now going to do the last stage of management for these double nukes. They were wintered indoors. We sometimes winter them indoors, sometimes outdoors, and wrapped up outside. These were wintered indoors. We moved them out early in March. It was quite warm then, and then we had a lot of cool weather. But they still have come along. They're now filling 4 to 5 frames of bees, and we need to get them out of there before they start thinking about preparing to swarm. So we'll be transferring them into full-size hives, and several weeks later we'll be making up some new hives, new double nucleus colony hives, so the cycle will start over again. These are the replacement for our winter losses. So we basically have replaced our winter losses a year ahead. They all have young queens in them, and they are ready to go. They'll build up pretty strongly and produce a good crop of honey for us this year. But now we need to get them out of the box and transfer them into their own hives. Dave's going to take care of that, coming right up.
Okay, so we're at the point where we're ready to now move these two colonies that are in this double nuke into their own separate colonies, or hive boxes. So to do that, pretty simple. We'll get to the frames in a bit, but you basically just need two single brood chamber hives ready to rock and roll, and then you can get working at that. So we'll go into this double nuke. And get things lined up. So we open this side. It's looking very good. There's adult bees from side to side. When we get into it, that's when we can have a look at the brood and where the colony's at that wise. So we're ready to go with this side. So in order to get things totally ready, what you want is to line up this side with the entrance. So this side of the double nuke has the entrance on this side. So we're gonna line that up with this single brood chamber box that we brought. So both the entrances are pointed the same way. And just to get ready, we have the same thing done with this single brood chamber. So the entrance for this side is on this side of the box, and we have the entrance pointing that way for that one. So again, we've seen the adult bees. They look good and strong. We want to get into that first frame in order to check where the brood situation is at. Now we got the first frame out. We're doing two things at once. We're on the lookout for the queen, but we're also looking at where the colony is at in its brood stage, its brood cycle. And on this frame, there is a lot of brood. There's eggs in there. So it's looking quite strong and quite healthy. So we're gonna start transitioning and transferring it over into that kind of final hive where it's gonna end up. Having a look for the queen. Don't see it. And the queen's in the box. So we'll catch her. They're always a little more difficult to catch when they're inside the box. So we can put her in a cage. And now we're ready to finish up with this side of the double nuke. So only 5 frames came out of that one, so we need to top this one up and make sure there's 10 frames in it. And I've already kind of sorted that out. So what you're gonna need is 2 foundation frames. And they go along the outside walls, so you can put those in. And then an empty frame. This one doesn't look the greatest, but it came from a dead hive. So we'll put that beside, just pick one side, doesn't matter which side, and put that beside the foundation frame. And then you're gonna grab 2 feed frames or honey frames, and that's what you're gonna put beside the bees. So you're going to be putting 3 frames on one side and 2 on another. You might need to move the frames around. It's important when you're doing this to make sure the frames that you take out of this double nuke kind of stay in the same order. The bees, because they're going into this size of a box and they're going to need to be keeping that warm, they really want the brood concentrated in the middle of that colony. So they have it sorted out. So if we just keep things in the same order, it should be pretty good to go. So we're done transferring, and that's ready to be a full-size colony. So I release the queen. There she is, and there she goes. So we're done with that one, so we'll cover it up while we work on the other half. So we'll put our inner cover and our lid on. And then we're ready to get going on that other half. And there she is. Grab her, put her in a cage. At this point, again, we're ready to fill this box right on up with the extra 5 frames. And again, I have that already picked out beside me. But you have your 2 foundation frames, and they go on the outside walls. Gonna have an empty frame. That was a little bit of a dirty one, but that'll clean that one up right up with all that wax moth. And then your 2 honey frames. So this frame has honey underneath all those cappings. Mm-hmm. And I just have to stick our 1 last honey frame in. Stick that right on in there. Space things out. Okay, so that's ready to go. We just need to release the queen. There she goes. We put our inner cover on. Next, our lid. And so now what we have to do, because both these have the same entrances oriented in the same way as that original double nuke, but they obviously can't go side by side. What we end up doing is we move this original double nuke out of its spot and then just choose one, move it on into the original spot, put the second one on top of that, keeping the entrances, one on top of each other, going the original ways. Now, on a nice day like today, which is typically when you'd be doing this, you just put the double nuke, the original double nuke on top, and kind of give the bees the chance to head back home to their new homes and clean this box up. Typically, overnight, all the bees get out of there. And that's transferring a double nuke into their own full-size colonies.